simplifying radicals with perfect squares and variables.
In this case, 36 is the perfect square. 36 is made up of 6 and 6. Because finding the square root of 36, one of the 6's is put outside the radical, the other is canceled out. Next, we have to find the square root of x squared. The only way to get x squared is to do x times x. Similar to what happened with the 6, one of the x's is canceled out, the other goes outside the radical. Finally, we have y to the third. To find the square root of y cubed, we have to separate y cubed into y squared and y to the first power. Once again, with y squared, one of the y's gets canceled out, the other goes outside the radical. Y to the first power stays inside the radical.
Simplifying radicals with imperfect squares and variables. When simplifying imperfect squares, it is best to begin by finding the prime factors of the number. In this case, 384 is inside the radical. First, 384 is separated into 16 and 24. 16 reduces into 4 and 4, which both reduce to 2 and 2. 24 reduces to 8 and 3. 8 reduces into 4 and 2, and 4 reduces into 2 and 2. Now, let's rewrite 384. Once we finish, we pull out one number from each pair, multiply them together, and place the final product outside the radical. The numbers left over get multiplied together and remain inside the radical. Once we complete that, we're still not done. We have to find the square root of x to the fourth power and y cubed. The square root of x to the fourth power is x squared, which goes outside the radical. To find the square root of y cubed, once again, we divvy it up into y squared and y to the first power. Y squared becomes y and goes outside the radical, and y to the first power stays in.